I'm Jevon with Pickard USA. Today I'm going to show you how to wreck an 08 and down Harley Davidson with our builder's net kit. Mark the frame a half inch behind the fork lock plate and draw a straight line down in front of the down tubes. I'm going to mark the line with tape so it's easier to see while cutting. It's really important to make sure your cut line clears the down tube of the frame for a nice clean cut. Before we cut the neck, we're going to take two measures with our angle gauge, one on the neck and one on the backbone. For the backbone measurement, I use an angle gauge and mark a reference point on the frame so I can refer to it later on. We also mark a reference point on the neck, use an angle gauge to take a measurement so we can refer to it later on. When cutting your neck, use a portable bandsaw or reciprocating saw to avoid excess heat. Do not use a cutoff. Using a grinder, we're going to clean up all the burrs and prep it for welding. Remove about a half inch of powder coat around the frame, being careful not to touch your VIN number. Repeat the same process on the neck. We're going to mark three plug weld holes about a half inch from the cut line, one on the top and one on each side. Mark one plug weld hole on each side of the neck. Using a quarter inch drill bit, drill the pilot hole for your plug welds. Do the same thing on the neck. Switch to a half inch drill bit to finish your plug weld holes. Use a hand file to deburr the inside of the frame and the inside of the neck. On the short end of the neck block, mark a line an inch and a quarter back and diagonally down to the corner so we can cut it off to make room for the neck. Use a grinder to deburr the neck block. Slide the block into the neck so we can weld it before mounting it to the jig. Tack the block to the neck before you weld it. Once you're tacked in, do your final weld. Slide the neck and the block into your frame and check with the angle gauge. Make sure you're 9 degrees over your initial neck angle. Put your angle gauge on the reference mark on your backbone. Make sure that hasn't changed. Tack the neck to the frame and double check all your measurements to make sure nothing has moved. If your neck and backbone measurement haven't changed, you're ready to weld. Let's fill in the plug weld holes. We're going to grind off all the powder coat on the skin of the frame, being careful not to touch a VIN number. If you notice, these two surfaces are at different levels. We're going to cut the edges here so we can drop the center piece before we connect it to the neck piece. I like to use a piece of tape to mark this line before cutting it. I'm going to cut from the front all the way down the line to the factory weld on both sides. Measure this distance so you can cut a piece and join the two. I'm gonna tack the pieces together before trimming the sides. Now that the center piece is tacked in, we can trim the excess on each side. Once the excess wall's been trimmed off, clean the area and we'll tack it in place. I used a piece of paper to cut out a template for each side. Then I transfer it over to sheet metal and cut it out. Test fit your piece, tack it in, then repeat it on the other side. Make a template for the bottom of the neck and cut it out of sheet metal. Then we'll tack it in. Once you've tacked in the skin, you can begin your final welding. Be sure to skip around to avoid excess heat. Once the frame's cooled down for welding, you can grind it and prep it for paint. If you have any questions about raking a Harley neck with a builder's kit, give us a call and be sure to ask about our front end packages.